Four Negro Girls in a Church by Phillip E. Hardy. Super. How do you fix hate? One person at a time. Catherine McKinstry. Fade in, super, September 15th, 1963. Exterior, 16th Street Baptist Church, day. It's a perfect late summer morning. The sun shines with a few clouds dotting the horizon. On a peaceful street corner stands an impressive red brick building with a dome in the center and two towers on each end. Clerestory windows surround the Gothic structure. Several children wearing their Sunday best ascend the stairs to enter the front door. Interior, ladies' lounge, day, continuous. Wearing crisp white cotton dresses, five young African-American girls, Addie May, 14, her sister Sally, 12, Denise, 11, Carol, 14, and Cynthia, 14, sit in the dressing area. Astute-looking Cynthia reads a Bible. On her index finger, we see a large silver ring with an emerald-colored stone. The three other girls are chatting and getting ready for Sunday choir.
You know Alicia from Avenue South?
Tall, gangly, nappy-headed thing?
Girls laugh.
That's her, all right.
What about her?
She was telling me about a thing called purgatory, where your soul goes to a place, something like a train depot.
What for?
She said it's a place where you bathe in fire to wash your sins.
We're Baptists. We don't believe in anything like that.
Cynthia closes her Bible, narrows her eyes.
There's only two places a soul goes, heaven or hell. Christians are saved by grace.
You should know that by now. That's why Jesus was the Lamb of God.
Addie puts her sweater on a hanger. Denise cocks her head.
But Alicia believes in Jesus too.
The Catholics like to complicate things.
Cynthia looks at Denise in earnest.
Read your scriptures, little girl. John 14:6. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me.
Now get your choir robes on. Service starts in a few minutes.
Exterior 16th Street Baptist Church. The peaceful setting is interrupted by a tremendous explosion. From several locations, balls of fire spew out like horizontal geysers, blasting out windows all around the building. The horrible noise of shattering glass and flying debris fills the air. Several cars in front of the church also explode and catch fire. The shrill dissonance of screaming voices emanates from inside the partially destroyed sanctuary. Disoriented children, led by a few shaken adults, begin exiting the front and side doors of the church. Some of the people are coughing from the smoke, now billowing out from the windows and blown-up walls. Outside the church, lacerated, bleeding victims who have been hit by shards of glass begin wandering up to the area of destruction. In the distance, blaring sirens. Interior basement. What was once a lounge is now a few pieces of partially standing wood framing. Various slivers, pieces of glass, mortar, rocks, and dirt are strewn out in a fearful shambles. Overturned furniture lies twisted in piles. From a large crater in the floor, Addie climbs out, dusts herself off. She stoops down and yanks Denise up out of the deep hole. Cynthia's head pops up. She reaches for a fallen beam, pulls herself up to what's left of the floor. Using the same beam, Carol climbs up with the other girls.
Anyone seen my sister?
Denise and Carol shake their heads. Cynthia points down into the large hole.
She's not down there. What happened here?
Cynthia looks around, shrugs.
I don't know.
Are we dead?
I don't know.
Are we in hell?
The other girls look at Cynthia.
I don't know.
Addie Mae also glances around at the destruction.
This sure ain't heaven.